Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to give someone everything they need. Tear you out from over under. What are you saying, Drew Hill?
God knows you're a sexy thing. He's taking everything in me. Not to kiss you over under feelings. I feel my thunder. How the hell could I not want you?
Girl, now get the to be afraid. I pray for you. You wait for me, baby. Ladies and gentlemen, you don't have to rush at all. Baby, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies and gents, YouTube has been messing with my microphone as of late. I'm sorry, been messing with the volume. So I apologize for that. But we gotta push on. We got some information for you. Some of you guys are gonna understand this right away, and many of you are not gonna understand it. We're going to take the scenario of buying a home. But don't worry about it. This is my conversation. Do not think that you know where I'm going, so shut it up. You just keep telling people to shut up. Shut up. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Telling somebody to shut up is not rude, especially if what they're talking about is coming out the side of their neck. You need to shut up before you lose all that blood and you die. Shut up. Okay. Most people who talk out the side of their neck, they ain't supposed to be talking out the side of their neck. If they're talking out the side of their neck, then they don't need to be listened to. You see what I'm saying? All right, I'm so glad you get it. No, I need it. It ain't supposed to be a thing. I'm sorry, Drew Hill, y'all. Ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Cisco, you got to stop because you guys are messing with my rhythm right here. This is the times. These are the times, y'all. Means so much more. You don't have to be. I'm sorry, apologize. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and give you guys the scenario so that you get it. Mama, he's a fool. Your mama's a fool. Mama, he said you a fool. Oh, you know that? Okay. She said it's all right. She knows she a fool. All right. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, an individual goes to a bank and they apply for a loan. The bank says, hey, you've been approved. Now go look for a home. And they go look for a home. And the bank says, hey, your loan just funded. All you got to do is come here and sign the papers. And they give a provisional credit to the seller of the home. And you sign the papers, which includes language that comes from Federal Reserve Operating Circular Number 10. Appendix number 3, which is called the U.S. Application Borrower's Packet. Okay. Application Packet for U.S. Borrowers. Now, you do all of that. Now, here's what's just happened. When you give it to the local Federal Reserve agent or the lender, after you sign it, it now becomes a, pay attention, security instrument. It is not a security instrument before that. It has to be accompanied with the Federal Reserve Operating Circular application. United States Borrower Application Packet. At that point, it becomes a security. Hold on now. Let me explain. You get to OID that security, but you don't want to do it right yet. Oh, no. You need some other things to take place before you can OID that original issuer's discount. Because there's going to be some adhesions. What? Adhesions to that contract. Adhesions? Adhesions to the contract. What are you talking about? Oh, well, see, now that the bank has a copy of the contract, they're going to make another copy. There are going to be two copies. They'll probably do 5, 6, 7, or 8. Okay, but they're going to do at least two copies, okay? One of the copies they're going to send to the Federal Reserve Board of Governors, who told them, all right, we approved the loan. Now, they're going to get paid from the Federal Reserve Board of Governors, but this ain't about that. We don't care about that right now. When the bank takes that promissory note and gives it to the Federal Reserve, it becomes, pay attention, another security. How so? Because the Federal Reserve now gives it to the Treasury.
So the Federal Reserve converts it to, pay attention, either a bond or another security. When they give it to the Treasury, who definitely converts it to a bond. Okay? So the bond that it's created as a result of transferring it to the Treasury is another conversion of your original instrument. Cha-ching for the total value. So add that value twice. So let's say it was $100,000. All right, we're going to add that $100,000 twice. That gives us $200,000. But hold on, we got the one that the bank does, and they convert it to, pay attention, a mortgage. It's no longer a promissory note. They call it a mortgage, and they trade it on the market as a mortgage-backed security. Really? So, cha-ching, that's number three. But wait a minute. We have one more. Oh, yes. The original one that went to the Federal Reserve, for which they use to pay the borrower, and it becomes a security. Cha-ching, number four. So $100,000, the original loan, has now become $400,000. Watch this. We're going to do some math. Oh, this is the wrong window. We got to go here. Oh, by the way, let's do this so that you guys understand about this video. We put the concept and the doctrine underneath. Okay, so all you need to do is go there and look at all of the stuff they're talking about there. And the link's right here underneath. Just go ahead and do it. Doctrine of capacities. We're doing the same thing here. It's exactly the same conversation, people. The doctrine of capacity. The note takes on a different capacity as it goes through the hands of each of the different agents. Watch this. Wake up. I am needing to do some math based on a particular scenario, and this deals with the doctrine of capacities, period. New line. A financial institution receives an initial application for a loan in the advancements of Federal Reserve notes from a U.S. borrower as identified under Section 16 of the Federal Reserve Act, paragraph numeral 1, paragraph numeral 2, paragraph numeral 4. No, that's not what I asked. So stop listening. Wake up. The borrower's loan is approved via the Federal Reserve Board of Governors, who issues Federal Reserve notes to the local Federal Reserve agent on behalf of the borrower. Period. When the borrower delivers the promissory note, and it is accompanied by the collateral security and application, application packet for U.S. borrowers, as identified by Federal Reserve Operating Circular Number 10, Appendix Numeral 3. It creates a security as identified by the March 9, 1933 Act. Period. This security is an OID for the borrower. period. When the bank delivers this security to the Federal Reserve Board of Governors, comma, they then become the OID for the security that they've issued to the Federal Reserve Board of Governors. Period. When the Federal Reserve Board of Governors issues the security to the United States Treasury, comma, they become the OID for the security issued to the Treasury, period. And when the Treasury converts the security to a bond, it becomes the OID for the issued security, period. When the bank or financial institution converts the security to a mortgage and trades it on the market, comma, it becomes the OID for the issued security, period. Each time the security is converted, comma, it takes on a different capacity and becomes a new instrument as a result of such conduct, period. I need 4 case citations evidencing this conclusion with specificity, exclamation mark. Stop listening. Ladies and gentlemen, you see, I just talked about 5 different conversions because that's all it is. We're doing conversions. A lot of people don't understand this, so I'm going to let him explain it to you. But you heard me explain it. Okay? No, nobody taught me this. This is just evidence and obvious stuff. But hold on. I don't even know what it's going to say, honestly. I don't have no idea what it's going to say. But then we're going to check the law.
Sure. Here are some case citations evidencing the conclusion that when a financial institution converts a security to a mortgage and trade it on the market, it becomes the OID for the issued security. 12 U.S.C. Section 248, A, 1, B. To make advances to member banks and other depository institutions, including insured non-member banks, on their promissory notes secured by satisfactory collateral. Federal Reserve Operating Circular No. 10, Appendix 3, Application Packet for U.S. Borrowers. March 9, 1933 Act, an act to provide relief to the owners of homes and farms and to refinance home mortgages. Treasury Directive 1501, Issuance and Management of Treasury Securities. In addition to these statutory and regulatory provisions, there is also a body of case law that supports the conclusion that a financial institution that converts a security to a mortgage and trades on the market becomes the OID for the issued security. For example, in Ren Ray, Lehman Brothers Holdings, Inc., 151 BR 929, Banker, SDNY 2000, the court held that a security that was originally issued to the Federal Reserve Board of Governors and then converted to a mortgage and traded on the market became the OID for the issued security.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I can't go by the quote that he's doing because it's not an exact quote from the court. But here, this is what you guys need to pay attention to. Its capacity. The instrument takes on a different capacity. When the borrower issued it, the borrower gave it to the bank. That becomes an OID for the borrower because they are the original issuer. But because the borrower has agreed that the note can be sold and or given to another, now when the other party, the bank, the financial institution, gives it to the Federal Reserve, they become the OID, the original issuer of that transference. And the Federal Reserve becomes the original issuer of that transference. And when the Treasury receives it and they convert it to a bond, they become the original issuer of that transference. And when the financial institution takes it, uses that as a collateral for mortgage-backed security, they become the original issuer of that transference. That's what is being said. Okay. Now, that you guys understand. You have the right to do an OID. You don't need to do all of the hoops and jumping through that you thought you needed to do in the first place. I've just showed you 4 different capacities one single note takes and where you, as the homeowner, and even with a student loan and a car loan, the same thing is the case. As long as there's a promissory note given to a local Federal Reserve agent, this is what goes on every single time. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't do this stuff for all of you because it's too much information to give it to you all at one time. You're going to have to do your research on this. But if you have the right to the original issuer's discount, then you're only getting the percentage on the note at maturity. You can call it early. You guys know about margin calls and all that. You can call the security in early. We're not talking about the mortgage-backed security, your security. You can do a margin call on your security with the bank. They are trading it, not on the market, but they traded it with the Federal Reserve Board of Governors. Do a margin call on your own security. They're going, what you talking about? You can't do that. Watch this. Wake up. Wake up. I have a promissory note that I gave to Wells Fargo Bank, comma, Wells Fargo Bank, when they received it, comma, received it as a security, as defined in law, period. I am the original issuer of that security, comma, Wells Fargo then took the security and gave it to the Federal Reserve Board of Governors, comma, under the doctrine of capacities, comma, they are the original issuers of the security they gave to the Federal Reserve Board of Governors, which is a separate and distinct security than the one I gave to Wells Fargo. Period. We now have three separate securities, comma, one held by my person, comma, one held by Wells Fargo, comma, and one held by the Federal Reserve Board of Governors, period. But Wells Fargo and the Federal Reserve Board of Governors must recognize my right to do a call on the security, period. Please provide the law specifying this, comma, and please explain why such a law exists and what are my rights under that law? Question mark. Stop listening. I'm going to let him finish. I don't know what he's going to say because I've not asked him these questions before. I'm only giving him logical questions and just seeing if I can direct him to provide the correct information. So, 1 second.
The doctrine of capacities is a legal principle that states that an entity can act in different capacities, depending on the context. In the context of securities law, the doctrine of capacities can be used to argue that a single security can be held by multiple entities in different capacities. In your case, you are the original issuer of the security. When you gave the security to Wells Fargo Bank, Wells Fargo became the holder of the security. When Wells Fargo gave the security to the Federal Reserve Board of Governors, the Federal Reserve became the holder of the security.
Now hold on. The securities, each time it goes to a different party, they may become the holder of the security that they receive, but it's not the same security because there has been an alteration. There has been a change. There's been a conversion. Your security, when you do a mortgage, gets changed by pay to the order of. Now it's not the same security because they've altered to security after you initially gave it to them. That means it's no longer the same security. That's why you get to keep a copy. You get to take on that copy and write the words legal copy. You get to do that legally. The Check 21 Act permits you to do that legally. 1 second. Sorry, got the heater on. And originally, when I woke up, it was 32 degrees in here. It's 61 degrees now, but it's too warm for me.
So I gotta definitely turn that heater off. All right. So when you gave it to Wells Fargo, Wells Fargo altered it. It becomes a new security for Wells Fargo because it still maintains a face value. This is not money. These are securities, people. How securities are created. When Wells Fargo gives a security, pay attention, to, what do you call that stupid bank? The Federal Reserve Bank Board of Governors. It becomes a different security with the Federal Reserve Board of Governors. However, Wells Fargo's security, because the Federal Reserve Board of Governors alters that one, Wells Fargo security now gets to be utilized as collateral, the same as you get to utilize your promissory note as collateral. And they create a mortgage-backed security. Okay? When they do that, these are different capacities of the same original instrument. Watch this.
However, you are still the original issuer of the security, and you still have the right to do a call on the security. This
wait,
is because
wait,
the
wait, wait. How come nobody ever talked about doing a call on somebody's security? I don't even know if that's right or not. We're going to do some more research on that on this video. 1 second.
Doctrine of capacities states that an entity can act in different capacities, even if those capacities are different from the entity's primary capacity. In your case, your primary capacity is that of an individual borrower. However, you also have the capacity to act as the original issuer of a security.
Yay!
The right to do a call on a security is the right to redeem the security before it matures. This right is typically granted to the issuer of the security, and it allows the issuer to repurchase the security from the holder at a predetermined price. In your case, you have the right to do a call on the security because you are the original issuer of the security. This means that you can redeem the security from Wells Fargo or the Federal Reserve Board of Governors at a predetermined price. The law that specifies your right to do a call on the security is the indenture for the security. The indenture is a legal document that outlines the terms and conditions of the security. It typically includes a provision that grants the issuer the right to do a call on the security. There are a few reasons why the doctrine of...
Hold on. All of you have this written into your contracts, by the way. It's the early redemption clause. You have the right to redeem your promissory note. And you have to pay dollar for dollar. You have the right to redeem your promissory note. And you have the right to repay dollar for dollar. You can do this one of two ways. You can do this through the Federal Reserve Board of Governors. You can let them know that I never received the promissory notes promise as required by law. I need those so that I can redeem my promissory note. Hold on now, did he just say, what did he just say? You have the right to call, contact, communicate with the Federal Reserve Board of Governors. Tell them Federal Reserve Act, section number 16, paragraph number 2 says that when I gave my promissory note and it was accompanied by Federal Reserve Operating Circular, appendix number 3, application packet for U.S. borrowers, they were supposed to give that to you and you guys were supposed to extend Federal Reserve notes to me. I never received the Federal Reserve notes. So either you provide documentation that you issued the Federal Reserve notes, or I want to do a call on my security and I want to offset it with the Federal Reserve notes that you never gave me. Ta-da! Changes everything, doesn't it? Let's continue.
Capacities exists. First, it allows entities to act in different capacities in order to meet their different needs. For example, a company may act in its capacity as a borrower when it borrows money from a bank, and it may act in its capacity as a lender when it lends money to another company.
Hold on now. Hold on now. Y'all just don't get it, and I know y'all don't get it because I know y'all. Hold on now. Hold on. So that y'all get it. Y'all, I don't know what's wrong with y'all people. We're going to go to page number 26. Hold on. No, y'all can't run ahead of me. U.S. borrower desiring capacity to request to borrow funds from their local Federal Reserve Bank should submit the following documents, forms of which are included in this appendix because they're operating as any Federal Reserve Bank. That is the capacity. The capacity to operate as a bank.
Sorry. I apologize. Hey, Bart, can you finish explaining that to them?
Second, the doctrine of capacities helps to protect the rights of entities. For example, if a company is sued in its capacity as a borrower, its assets in its capacity as a lender will not be subject to seizure. In your case, the doctrine of capacities allows you to retain your right to do a call on the security, even though you have given the security to Wells Fargo or the Federal Reserve Board of Governors. This is important because it allows you to protect your investment in the security.
Look, ladies and gentlemen, I know for a fact that ain't nobody else ever talked about this. But I guarantee you they're gonna be talking about it now. Y'all don't have to give me credit for the stuff that I give you, but I guarantee you one thing, you cannot watch none of my videos and not learn something. That I guarantee. So, despite whatever people might say about this man, well, technically, they can't say anything negative about me, period. My life has been dedicated to helping people for the entirety. Made some purposeful mistakes. But guess what? Going on 30 years, nobody can point a finger. I can point one. I got two of them where you can come and sit and spin if you got something you want to say contrary to what I just said. Just sit and spin. We'll just sit up here and keep pushing you like you're on that merry-go-round, but you can sit and spin and go, wee! All right. Ladies and gentlemen, those of you who really need to understand what's going on here, I didn't go into any detail. I'm just explaining something generally. It's up to you to do the research. I just brought up a simple scenario. If they want to foreclose on your note saying you failed to pay, then do a call on the security. You have a right to do that. The next video I do will tell you on how to do a call on the security and the laws supporting that. So stay tuned. Yes, it's a lot of information this weekend, isn't it? You just need to understand there's going to come a time where I'm not going to be able to communicate with people and give them information. So I'm trying to put out as much as I can. So y'all just stay with me.